A sea of umbrellas out in the crowd today as we head into practice. It's going to be especially difficult to navigate the circuit in some very tricky conditions. So I hope our drivers have come prepared. No cars on track just yet then. We'll be getting the green light in a couple of minutes. And all eyes are fixed on the sky. Anthony Davidson, I think they're hoping to spot a nice patch of blue heading this way.
Doesn't look like it's going to happen anytime soon though, does it? I'm not sure how many teams will be willing to send their cars out in these conditions, to be honest. There are guys out in the pit lane with leaf blowers trying to clear the worst of the standing water away, but it seems like a bit of a futile effort as things stand right now. Of course, the best way to clear water is to get cars out on track. The trouble is, no one wants to be the first one out there. As soon as one or two sensible lap times appear on the monitors though, more are guaranteed to follow.
That's fantastic. You obviously have a really good understanding of this circuit. Test complete, and that was a very good job indeed. We got okay, super job so far. We're getting great data. Stay focused. It's our primary target time. We're happy with that.
Hello and welcome from the Circuit Gilles Villeneuve, home to the Canadian Grand Prix, for today's qualifying session. And as we wait, poised for the start of what will hopefully be a thrilling qualifying, why don't you tell us, Anthony Davidson, about the things you can do to really get the most out of a car in a session like this?
Well, you're largely limited by the Parc Fermé regulations, of course. Back in the old days, pre-2004, you'd work on both a qualifying setup and a race setup over practice, and then swap them over after qualifying. So the race car was quite different at times to the qualifying car. Nowadays, though, you have to find a compromise that works for both. There are a few things that you can still adjust during the session, such as the differential, the brake bias, and the front wing angle, but that's about it. So it's more about optimizing what you do have and adapting your own style to suit the track conditions.
Just 30 seconds left in the session.
We're back once again beside the St. Lawrence River here in Montreal for the Canadian Grand Prix. The event first moved to a variant of this track back in 1978. It was won by none other than Gilles Villeneuve, the first Canadian to ever win his home race, and in whose honour the circuit would be renamed. With top speeds of around 210 miles per hour heading into the overtaking opportunity of turn 13, the 2.7 miles of the Circuit Gilles Villeneuve are some of the quickest on the Formula One calendar. There are 14 corners in total, with 60% of the lap taken at full throttle, and average lap speeds clock in at about 130 miles per hour. With me today, of course, is Anthony Davidson. Now, I want to talk to you about Valtteri Bottas. That was a great win in the last race. Can they keep that momentum going this weekend?
There are never any guarantees in this business, but certainly the performance last time out would have boosted their confidence coming into this one.
It's time to see how our drivers are stacking up after yesterday's exciting qualifying session. Sebastian Vettel has a clear track ahead of him today. He starts in pole position, and it's Lewis Hamilton alongside. As we continue through the rest of the grid today, we have Verstappen, Leclerc, Valtteri Bottas, and Albon, Ricciardo, Perez, Stroll, and Kevin Magnussen, Raikkonen, Sainz, Nico Hülkenberg, and Norris. Midas, Giovinazzi, Romain Grosjean, and Daniel Kvyat. Gasly and George Russell ends our grid lineup. Now it's almost time to lights out, so let's go down to the track.
Okay, be wary of the cars ahead braking suddenly into one. We could ruin our race if we hit them. Good luck. If you can, we need to make sure the engagement is okay before the start. We're going to want to put some temperature into the tyres and brakes. We need to keep the engine cool though, so don't go too high with the revs. Let's focus now for the rest of the race. Has been enabled. strategy is available on the MFT. Teammate by 6.0 seconds. set of rubber is looking a bit worse for wear at this point. It's not going to be long before it falls away from us completely. Stay alert. Right, some information on Ricardo. They have some kind of mechanical problem. Don't forget, box this lap. Go, go, go! Okay, you only have to stop once now. One stop left. Stop. The gap to the car ahead is 2.5 seconds. is 2.3 seconds. It seems they fixed whatever the problem was. They're coming back up to speed. Is coming to fit the mediums. Car ahead, now running medium tyres. caution, yellow flags ahead. No overtaking through the caution zone. Be careful until you see the greens. The track is clear. Green flag. Teammate behind is 16.2 seconds. We're starting to see a bit of tyre wear. You shouldn't have too much trouble for the time being, but the grip is going to start falling away. Conditions look stable at the moment. No rain currently expected. Drys seem like the best tyre for now. push now. We're boxing this lap. The car behind is gaining on you by 5/10 a lap. Racing on the exit. Release, release. Okay, stay clear of the white line on the exit. We'll receive a penalty for dangerous driving if you cross over into the track. George in the pits. by 29.2 seconds. Engine mode much longer, we're about a lap over target. Drop down to mix too soon. Laps of fuel remaining. nice overtake. The gap to the car ahead is 2.3 seconds. The car behind is dropping back. We're seeing a gap form. This is your final lap of the race. There's only one lap of fuel remaining.
So Mercedes have won it, and what a great race it was. Tell me, Ant, how did they manage to achieve this win?
Well, tyre management probably played quite a large role in the outcome of this one. As ever, it's not just about speed, it's all about maintaining that speed consistently over a stint, over a race distance. So being able to keep up the lap times while still being smooth on the controls and gentle on the tyres, that's really where the race was won today.
And I can see the drivers starting to approach the podium for the victory celebrations. A real team victory today. Everybody played their part. Congratulations then to Mercedes, your race winners today. And now let's take a look at the driver's standings. It's a great result for Lewis Hamilton, who moves further ahead at the top of the table. Some amazing talent out on the track today. But Anthony, who would you pick as your driver of the day?
I'll probably go for Pierre Gasly. The team did a good job with the strategy to put him in amongst the pack, but it's the driver's job to capitalise on those opportunities, and he did so with a lot of skill.
It's time to check out the constructors' standings. Mercedes continue to extend their lead. Meanwhile, good work from Racing Point this weekend, who pushed themselves further up the order. Well, that was certainly an incredible weekend of racing. Be sure to join myself and Ant for more exciting Formula One action soon.
good day today. Let's have your take on it. It's safe to say you're smashing everyone's expectations, isn't it? Things looked close between you and your rival for a bit, but you came out on top, didn't you? Great. Well, that's everything.